Today we're going to talk about using the filter function in Excel. So in this example here, we have an employee directory. We have a set of data that contains employee ID, employee name, the department, and the location. And what we'd like to do is insert a filter function that will return a subset of data from this larger set based on criteria we specify. We're going to insert the filter function. The array is just going to be this entire set of data. This next argument is our criteria. So it consists of our criteria column, which we're going to start out by just looking at the location. So I'll select this criteria location column. And then I'm going to insert an equals symbol because we want to say anything in this column is equal to our criteria main office. And this next argument is optional. It's essentially an if error argument or the value you want to return if nothing is found. Pretty standard to just insert a double quote there to return nothing if nothing's found. So I'll hit enter. You can see this returns everything from our data set where the location is the main office. So what if we wanted to have more than one criteria? So we would select our array again like normal. But the second argument, the include, is going to be a little different. It is one argument, but we're going to insert two criteria columns and two criteria values. So they need to be enclosed in parentheses and multiplied by each other. I'll explain why you have to do that in a moment. So we're going to select our location column. It's going to be equal to our main office criteria. I'm going to multiply that by our next criteria column and value. So our next criteria is going to be the department. That is equal to IT. So now you have to multiply these together because this is an array condition, and this produces a series of true falses, and the numerical equivalents of true and false in Excel are ones for true, zeros for false. So what this does is anytime there's a match on both sides that is in the same parallel array, it multiplies one times one and then says, yes, this is truly a true value. So that is how that works, and that's why you have to multiply these two conditions by each other. So you can see this produces everyone who is both in the IT department and works at the main office. So what if we wanted to have a criteria that was either one of these? It could be they worked in the main office or they are part of the IT department. Well, if we go back into our function, all we need to do, rather than multiply the two criteria columns together, you're simply going to insert a plus, because then it adds the one trues plus the other one trues from your second criteria column. So if you do that, you get anyone who is either in the IT department or works at the main office.